Today we are going to see another mechanism of connecting to your EC2 instances with temporary credentials. Security is getting a lot of focus nowadays, and one of the common areas of focus is removing long-term credentials. And when it comes to EC2, we quite often launch the EC2 instances with SSH key pairs, and once the instances grow or the environment grows, you have a lot of instances with a lot of different keys, and it becomes very difficult to rotate these keys or change the keys which are conforming to the security standards which are constantly changing. Amazon has launched a new feature called as EC2 Session Manager, which allows you to connect to your EC2 instances with temporary credentials. What it means is that you can launch your servers without any key pair at all and get access to the servers through this new feature, which leverages your SSM agent that should be running in your account. They have written a nice blog article detailing all the steps that are required to get it up and running in your account. There are a couple of prerequisites in my opinion. One is your SSM agent should be running in your account, and it should be of the minimum of this version or the latest version. And your operating system should be supporting the SSM agent, obviously. And also your EC2 instance should also have a role attached with this privileges so that you can connect to that instance. I have a demo instance set up in my account. As you can see here, I don't have any key pair attached, or I don't have any IAM role attached. So when I go to my session manager account, if I go here, this is the AWS SSM, and on the left hand side you have session manager. And as of now, you don't see any instances here right now. So let us go ahead and add a role so that the instance is detected here and it will start showing so that you can connect to it. Let us go ahead and create a role. We want the role to be assumed by EC2. So click on that and click on next. And the role had the word core. This is the role, AWS SSM Managed Instance Core. If you want to know, you can just go back to your blog article and confirm that. Click on next. Let us give a name. So we have our role created, and an instance profile is also already created since we did it in the GUI. All we are left to do is attach this role to our EC2 instance now. So let us go ahead and choose the EC2 role we just now created. Click on apply. Since the agent is already running, because I'm running an Amazon Linux, if you are running a Red Hat or Ubuntu, make sure that your SSM agent is already installed. And once you have that agent installed and the role also attached, it just takes a few minutes for the instance to show up here. So let us click on start session, and you find your instance here. This is the same instance that we have as our demo instance. Select on this. If you have your role not configured, or if there is an issue with the permissions, you'll get a message saying you have an instance with a supporting agent, but the role is not configured properly. So if you still think that there is something wrong, you can just go ahead and try and reboot, but it would not be necessary. So let us select on that and click on start session. And there you go, you got connected to that instance. Now by default, it goes into a shell. If you want bash, you can just go ahead and add bash, and then you can do a df-h, or if IP is supported, we can see the IP addresses also. So this is the same instance that we have as a demo running up. You can check the IP address also if you want, 172.31.89. You can go ahead and confirm this here, 172.31.89. The interesting thing about using Session Manager is you will have a session history for all the servers, and all that information is logged in here, like who is connected and what time the session started, what time the session ended, and all that information. And you can also log all the commands that are running on that particular session. If you go ahead and configure your preferences, you can choose a CloudWatch log group or an S3 bucket, and you also can encrypt it also. Make sure that if you're enabling these two features, the role has permissions to write to CloudWatch and S3. So once you do that, what happens is all the commands that is run by that user on that server will be logged in, so that you will have an audit trail of what is happening on the server, and you can go and fix if something goes wrong as well, or you can prove that this was a legitimate access to the server. So this is how you can get rid of permanent credentials from your account. Go ahead and try this in your account. If you have any problems, put them in the comment section. We can learn from each other. Thanks for watching. Happy learning.